Hey guys, this is Divyansh Garg here. Welcome to HNI Tech Minds, and this is the part 2 of Adobe Premiere Pro. Right, we are learning the complete guidance for Adobe Premiere Pro. Right, this is part 2 of that. If you have not visited part 1 for the introductory part, who all ever has the beginners, right? Just new in the field of editing, video editing, right? It's necessary for you to visit that video. If you are already know some parts of the video editing, that was just the introductory part. No need to visit it. Start from this part. Here we'll be learning some effects and transitions, right? So let's start with it without wasting any more time. So here was the part where we left before, right? In that previous part. So in this video now, I will be telling you how to add effects in a particular photo, right? First, right, we have imported some photos. That is here. You can directly drag and drop from here also, right? Like this directly, or you can first come it over and then drag it over here. It's your choice completely. It doesn't matter at all, right? It's very small. You can see it over here. We can increase the time limit. It's the time limit of that for this much time only the photo will be visible to us. Let's increase the time little bit, right? So that it would be clearly visible as the effects, right?
Hey guys,
you can see the pic is just visible as, but it's not looking good because it's just in the center of my face. That doesn't look. We wanted it at a particular corner, right? Sorry for that. You can click it over here. There are 2-3 methods you can adjust the photo size and like that. First, I would be telling you this method. First, click it on the picture in the timeline. You can see it, that pink color, right? Pink color, if it is coming over here, you can click it and go to the effect controls. Here you can see it over here. In the source, where my point is here, in the source here. Effect controls, right? You can see it over here. That is, first part is the position, right? Here, this much is the position, we can adjust it, like, see? If we are in, this is the x-axis and now 540 is the y-axis. Let's take it, we have to shift it to the top right corner, right? Let's just place it over there. Let's adjust, this is the complete size of a photo, that is 100. We have to adjust and make it the small pic over here. That should just tell us the logo, that is, it is the logo of our page, right? Let's decrease the size. You can put your number over here. It's your choice, or do it and like drag over here. It's your choice. How much you find it easy. This much is good, I think. It's just introductory. You can again drag it over here like this, over here and above. It's completely your choice how to make it, right? So there are other methods as well. How there you can click on the pic in the program, that you can click over here on our pic, double tap it over here and then drag it. You can drag it anywhere, sorry. You can increase the size and then drag it over anywhere. By also here you can directly increase or decrease the size. And even rotate the pic as you want, right? This was the complete. There are two mainly methods. By going to effect controls, you can drag and adjust the image over there, or otherwise you can directly drag or in the effect controls, right? These were the two methods how you can adjust the image over there. So now we'll be further adjusting it. Let's adjust it here in the down right corner. Right.
Welcome back to the channel Techlines.
Right. So this was how you can adjust the image. I am increasing the size just now to show some more effects, right? How you can do the more effects. That is the photo effects mainly, how the transition happens in that. If it would be small, it would not be visible to you. That's why I am increasing the size over here. It is just the sample one, right? Not actually any video. So I'll tell you, you can go to the effects part. First go to the this import part where we imported our files, right? That is videos and photos where we imported. Go to that part over here, and there are many functions like media browser, libraries, info, and next one is effects. This one, right? Go to the effects part over here. There are many like present, audio effects, audio transitions, video effects, and video transitions. You can apply this applicable for all, right? I will be explaining you everything one by one, but step by step, right? We'll be not rushing towards it. By going, we'll be going step by step over here. First, that is video transitions. Sorry. It got me. There are many. How we want the transition? We want 3D motions. 3D motions are mainly used when you doing ad. Mainly in Adobe After Effects, right? I will be making the videos on that also. When you make an ad, a specific ad, we want that the photo should be rotated like this or anti-clockwise. Like this, the 3D motions look good at that time only. Now, first of all, I'll tell you about dissolve. Like here, when we, just a minute, you can see. When we start a video,
hey guys, welcome back to Channel Techlines. Myself,
the photo is directly coming to the face. It's not blurring the effect or anything. It's directly appearing, which doesn't seem a good part from my side, right? Directly appearance is not called a good part over here. If it comes in slow motion or anything like that, it would be okay, right? You can add additive dissolve or cross dissolve according to you. Like, see, here additive dissolve was the coming by shading part. First lightening and then darkening the image. I'll show you once again, hope it's visible.
Hey guys, welcome back to Channel Techlines. Myself, Devansh
here. See, hope it's visible to you, right?
As we know that
this kind of, there are many, you can use any of your choice. There is additive dissolve, cross dissolve also. Let's show you that also, cross dissolve.
Hey guys,
playing it.
Welcome back to Channel Techlines. Myself, Devansh here.
See, this was the cross dissolve. There are many dip to black, dip to white. Dip to black means first the screen will get black and then the picture will be visible. And same as of white, first the image would be getting white and then the image would be visible. First the screen would be getting white, right? And then it's the film dissolve, morph cut. These are all the dissolve, right? You can use one by one and try it yourself, right? It's not at all like that. You have to only put drag one image. You can drag as many images you want, right? Here I'll show you some function related to that. Just a minute. See, I'm dragging another image as well over here and increasing the size. Hope it's visible now, right? Here you can place it next to this also. Just a minute, I make the size smaller. See, this image is visible.
And has an average speed.
And now there will be a different image, right?
Of 65 to 80 per words per minute.
See, directly other image found out. There are different images, right? You can choose as many images. Hope there is a complete, you have set up a complete video, you have edited, right? But now you have to place a picture in that video. But you can't, it would be a great problem. The whole your edited video would get destroyed. Don't take tension, it would not be there, right? You can place it in the different cells, right? Like I placed, there was the other one, right? You can place it on the top of the other. See, before this was a big one, right? You can put above this image. There are different timelines over here, different parts of the timeline, right? the topmost point, that is topmost part of the timeline, would be visible to you, visible to us in the video, right? Here you can see there are two top one is this image that is visible right now. Tech Minds, grow your thinking. That's our slogan, right? Grow your thinking. This is visible, right? And before that, there was this image, Tech Mind, which is our logo, right? A kind of a logo, not exact. There would be a complete logo, would be releasing soon, right? It would come any day. I'm working on it right now. And there was a video going on before it also, right? Which was my video I have spoken, right? There are two videos going under one, right? But how much we are visible? Which one is the visible? The topmost one, which is placed above the cells, right? This is the main function of timeline, right? How to adjust the things. Now, hope like these are two images coming together. Right. After you can see the images changing. The image is changing directly, which would not looking good, right? Directly popping to the eyes doesn't look nice. Then we again go to the effects over here in the importing part where we imported our videos. Go to dissolve and dip to white. Let's take this and place in between these two joints. There would be a small sign. Hope it's visible to you. Otherwise, you can try it yourself on your own, right? It would be completely visible. Any doubts for that, you can comment down in the comment section. Feel free to ask me the questions, right? You can see now. Yeah, the screen got wide and then it get it to the other picture. You can see once more. Like that. It was directly, not directly popped. It was first shifted to white screen and then slowly our picture was visible. These are the simple effects mainly used in the video transitions. Sorry again. Video transitions, right? There are many you can use about like this. You can place it in the timelines or anything else. Hope you, if this part, there is another part like, hope this video is going on and you want to delete some part of the video and you want to cut that part, right? Let's hope we take it from the here and now select this timeline, which is our main video going on, right? I selected this part now and I want a cut over here where this green line is, blue line is printed, right? Timeline is going on. I want to cut from here to the rest of one. I forgot it to do it in my this zone, that was source zone, right? Here I had not done it. So what I should do it now to cut that? This is simple keyboard keys you can use, that is Control K. If you have not finding it or anything else, you can go to this help option at the top and go to the keyboard, right? Sorry, just a minute. Sorry, it got the site open, right? That was not okay. Hey, you can go to the system compatibility keyboards right here. There are different types. Just a minute, I got over here. It was in the file section, I think. So, sorry for that. Yes, here in the get properties file section, you can get it to here, or even in the help of keyboard, you can get to the site and there all the keyboard shortcuts which are used in the Premiere Pro is given. You can go to that site also. If you want, I would be telling you in the next video also. Don't worry about that, right? So that was all about the part 2 of the Adobe Premiere Pro tutorials, right? We'll be continuing in the next video, that is part 3, right? We'll be further discussing the video effects over there. Here we have discussed the photo effects mainly, which were there. You can apply different types of effects I would be talking. And there are some effects which are auto-generated. They're placed in the Premiere Pro only, which can we can directly use them, right? We don't need to make them or anything like that. Right? We will be all completely discussing about it in our next video, that is part 3 of Adobe Premiere Pro, right? So till then, thank you. Hope you like this video and don't forget to subscribe our channel. It just took 3 seconds to subscribe it. So don't forget it to subscribe it. Thank you.